Hello my dear students, welcome back with a new video. Today's topic is about the 14th barometer. Means it is a modified form of the simple barometer, or you can say it is updated version of the simple barometer. See, we have seen in case of simple barometer there are so many demerits, that all the demerits has been removed in this case, means in simple barometer. So let's start the topic, which is 14th barometer. Now this is the construction of the simple barometer, where the tube is used whose length is 85 to 90 centimeter, and its one end is closed and another end is open. Okay, now look here, one leather cap is there and which contains the mercury. This we can say as trough, and after that fill the tube with the mercury completely, and then inverted into the trough which contains the mercury. We can say that completely filled tube or glass tube, it is dipped into the mercury of the leather cap. Okay, this glass tube is covered with the brass case. This is the brass case by which we can protect the glass tube, and at the bottom one screw is attached. What is the advantage of using screw? See, by using the screw we can raising up or the lowering down of the mercury level, means that level. By rotating the screw we can raising up or lowering down the surface of the mercury. One scale is attached with the glass tube. This is called the main scale. This is main scale. This one is main scale, MS I am writing, and this scale is attached. This scale is vernier scale to calculate the accurate reading. And remember that, or make sure that the level of the free surface of the mercury that will touch with the zero mark of the main scale. Okay, and that zero mark of the main scale, and this is called the ivory point, means there is a pointer. This point will touch with the surface and with the zero mark also. Means we can say that zero mark and the pointer, means that ivory pointer, they lie at the same straight line. Okay, because see, at the same time that free surface will touch at the zero mark as well as at the pointer, I mean at the ivory pointer also. You can say that zero mark of the main scale, it is at the tip of the ivory point, which is visible from the outside. In the upper part of the brass case there is one slit. This is the slit. It is used to note the level of the mercury. Here the vernier scale, I told, the one vernier scale is attached to get the accurate reading with the main scale. This vernier scale is attached with the main scale also to get the accurate reading. And one thermometer is there which can measure the temperature. Means suppose at a temperature, at room temperature, how much the atmospheric pressure, that I can calculate. Otherwise when the temperature is increasing, then it will record the temperature, and by the height we can measure the atmospheric pressure also. So at what temperature, how much the atmospheric pressure, that I can calculate, or we can calculate by the 14th barometer. Okay, how to find the value of atmospheric pressure? To find the value of atmospheric pressure, we need the height of the mercury level. Means height means here the scale is attached with the vernier scale, and vernier scale is attached with the main scale. So this is the mercury level. When the mercury level is fixed over here, then we can able to find the length. So if we get the length, means height, h, then by applying the formula P equals to h rho g, then easily we can able to find the value of atmospheric pressure. That's why the scale is used over here. Now how the height of that mercury level is measured? So to measure the height of the mercury level, we have to use the screw. What is the uses of screw? So make sure that when you are measuring the length or the height of the mercury level, then the free surface of the mercury that will touch at the pointer, means ivory pointer, as well as the zero mark. Okay, so to do this one we have to use the screw. So by rotating the screw we can raise the mercury level, or we can lower the mercury level also. So suppose at a particular place, we have to measure the atmospheric pressure, means that height we have to measure. So first we will rotate the screw. So we will check that free surface of the mercury in the trough, it is touching with zero mark or at the ivory pointer or not. So here that we have to check this point, means that free surface will touch at the ivory pointer as well as at the zero mark. Then we will measure that height, means suppose this is the position of the mercury level. This is the position of the mercury level. So here one scale is attached. This is the main scale, which is in millimeter. This is in millimeter mm. This scale is in millimeter. So by this scale we can able to measure, and also we will use the vernier scale also. So how to calculate the height of the mercury level, means length we need to find. See, we told the length of the glass tube is from 0 to 90 centimeters. So I have converted into millimeter, from centimeter to millimeter. That's why I have written 0 to 900 millimeter, because that scale is in millimeter. And one vernier scale is attached. So how to take the vernier reading? Look, suppose you consider the mercury level coincides with 760 millimeter. At 760 millimeter, this line gives the 760 millimeter. Okay. Now how to get the total reading? Look, one vernier scale is attached. You have to take the vernier reading also. But before starting, I want to say the least count of the vernier scale. What is it? The least count, LC I am writing, least count of the vernier scale is the one smallest division of the main scale, which is 1 millimeter. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, like this it is given. So one smallest division means 1 millimeter. And divided by total number of the vernier scale, which is from 0 to 10, means total number is 10. So this will be 0.1 millimeter. So we can write 0.01 centimeter. But here only this one is needed, because all the calculation I am doing in millimeter. So how to take? Look, here this line is 760 millimeter, where the mercury level coincides. Now one point you have to find, means from 0 to 10, that point will remain at the same straight line. What is the meaning? Means check, one line will be there which is matching with that line. Means that line and this line will remain at the same straight line. Again I am telling, out of 0 to 10, that total number of vernier scale is 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, like this it is given. So out of this 10 line, out of these lines, one line will be there. That line will match with the 760 line. Okay, means this line. They will remain at the same straight line. That line you have to find from the vernier scale. Means the line you have to find which is matching with the line where the mercury level coincides. Means this line and this line will remain at the same straight line. Suppose this line is number obviously 8, because this is 10, 9, and this will be 8. So plus 8 into vernier, means least count of the vernier scale, which is 0.1. So all are in millimeter we got. So 760 plus 0.8 millimeter. So it will come 760.8 millimeter. So this is the total height of the mercury level. So by using the formula P equals to H rho G, we can able to find the value of atmospheric pressure at that particular places, or from that thermometer also we can able to find the temperature also. Suppose the room temperature is near about 25 degree centigrade. So at 25 centigrade temperature, how much is the atmospheric pressure? That I can calculate by the formula H, where H equals to millimeter. So it's better if you convert that, because all you have to put in SI unit, because this is given in SI, 13.6 into 10 to the power 3, and this is 9.8 in SI. So try to convert this one in millimeter to meter you will convert, then you will put it. This is how we can able to find the value of atmospheric pressure. This is all about the Photon's barometer, and after that we will study about the aneroid barometer, because this is also not portable. It is very difficult to displace from one place to another place. That's why this is the one of the most demerits of the 14th barometer. That's why we will study about the aneroid barometer. Okay, here maximum demerits of the simple barometer has been removed, means where glass cap is there, there is also protection of the trough. So that all the demerits has been removed, but this is also not portable. This is very difficult to displace from one place to another. That's why we have to study about the aneroid barometer, which is portable. Okay, so today's class up to this. Next class I will discuss about the aneroid barometer. Thank you.